Saylor was born 6.5 weeks early. The neonatologist came down and said, Mrs. Pearson, I have some bad news. We believe your daughter was born with a severe heart defect. Day two of her life, that's when we heard horrible news. We didn't know if she had any connection between her heart and her right lung. We did not know if Saylor would survive. It was very clear soon after we started asking questions and researching that Children's Los Angeles was the only place for Saylor.
She came to Children's Hospital with a very complex form of tetralogy of Fallot, where the pulmonary artery arising from the right ventricle doesn't connect normally to the lung.
We took it minute by minute. We lived just for that day, and we didn't know what the next day would bring. We have been very blessed with Saylor, and she's had 4 open heart surgeries, and then one other surgery wasn't considered open heart, but they had to go in. The last surgery that we had was in June of 2015. After that, I remember Dr. Starnes sitting down with us and just kind of breathing. And that was the first time that we felt, okay, she's gonna do this. Like, she's gonna do this. And she's doing great. Looking at where we started with Saylor in life and then looking 5.5 years down the road, we never imagined one of the best heart surgeons in the world sitting down with us and saying, her heart is functioning the way we want it to function. Show us those muscles. Show us those CHLA muscles.
Saylor's strong.